Hello and welcome back in this new episode of the Python Physics Engine series. In the last episode, we have seen how to create particles. In today's episode, we will create an histogram for viewing the Boltzmann distribution. First of all, let's create an histogram class. The histogram must start somewhere, ends somewhere, and its base must have a defined Y level. Then, with the number of subdivision, we can calculate the width of each little spaces. Remember that a big N means more details, but a slower process. And how can we build the histogram from these properties? We start from the left down corner in x equals start, y equals level. Then we rise to the top of the first rectangle, located in x equals start, y equals level plus first height. Then we move to the right by the hex amount, and finally we come back to level y. This process must be repeated for all spaces. These two lines of code implement what I've just described. It remains only to calculate those heights. To evaluate them, we enter in the calculate speed function. It takes in input all the particles, their number, the number of subdivision, and a multiplicative factor. In the first part, we understand the maximum velocity of the little demons that moves around the screen. And if more than 5 particles has a speed bigger than the max speed, we increment these amounts. Here we multiply that speed by 1.2 to avoid that all particles are possible in the right edge of the histogram. Finally, we create the n subdivision interval full of zeros, and from that, every time the program sees a particle, it increases the proper subdivision group, the one that contains the velocity of the particle, by a multiplicative factor. So it starts like this, and we build it like this. Simultaneously, you can use this function to calculate the mean speed of the particles, useful to understand the temperature of the system. And if we implement the proper changement in draw function, we obtain this. Important things. First, the temperature just fluctuates under a mean value around the 666 Conti degrees, my personal unit of measure. This happened because we don't add or subtract any heat or any energy from the environment. They are just particles moving around in a closed box without friction. And second, after a while, the distribution matched perfectly with the Boltzmann one. And it is amazing. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. See you on next tutorial.